Om Namah Shivaya students. Today we are going to start with Legal Studies Class 11, Chapter Unit 2, Nature and Sources of Laws, Chapter 3, Part 4, Sources of Law. In the previous session, we had a discussion about the judicial precedent. In this session, we are going to have a discussion about the hierarchy of courts in British India, JCPC, hierarchy of criminal justice system, hierarchy of civil judicial system, and finally we will read about the do judges make laws. Then it will be followed with the assignment related to this session, that is chapter 3, part 4. Now let us look at the hierarchy of the courts in British India through flowchart representation. Hierarchy of courts in British India. At the topmost is the Privy Council, followed with the Federal Court and High Courts. Privy Council students are the courts that look after the cases related to the Britishers. Federal Courts are the court that is existing for the provinces in India, the other provinces in India. High courts are the courts that are not under the Privy Council or the Federal Court, but it is existing for the provinces and have their own judicial authority. The high courts are further subdivided into the Presidency Court in town and Mofussil Court in district. This is about the hierarchy of the courts in British India. Now let us read about this in detail. However, post-independence, India adopted its own constitution, which provided for a hierarchical judicial system. Students, this we have learned in our previous classes in class 5 to 10 as well. We have also learnt about this in our political science class about the hierarchy of courts in India. Now let us just have a revision of this in legal studies and understand the legal terms related to this. Hierarchical judicial system, that is pyramidal in nature. At the pyramidal in nature means it is in the shape of the pyramid. At the top is the Supreme Court, followed with the High Court and other subordinate courts. Under the Constitution of India, a single monolithic unified command of the judiciary has been established. That means a centralized judicial system is established. The Supreme Court of India, which was established by the Constitution of India, came into existence on 28th January 1950 under Article 124(1) of the Constitution of India. The Supreme Court replaced the Federal Court established by the Government of India Act of 1935. The Supreme Court of India is at the apex or at the top court in the hierarchy of the courts, followed by the High Court at the state level. Below them are the District Court and Session Judges Court. The structure of the judiciary in all states is almost same, with little variation in nomenclature of the designation. That means the little variation in the designation of the judges and the courts. The Judicial Committee of the Privy Council, that is JCPC, is one of the highest court in the United Kingdom. Established by the Judicial Committee Act 1833 to hear appeals formerly heard by the King in councils. It is the highest court of appeal for several independent Commonwealth countries, the British Overseas Territories, and the British Crown dependencies. It is often referred to as the Privy Council, as in most cases, appeals are made to Her Majesty in Council, that is the British monarch, as formally advised by her Privy Councillors, who then refers the case to the Judicial Committee for advice. The report of the Judicial Committee is always accepted by the Queen in Council as judgment. The panel of judges, typically 5 in number, hearing a particular case is known as the board. So this is about the Judicial Committee of the Privy Council, the highest court of authority in United Kingdom. You can see over here, court 3 in the Middlesex Guildhall, the normal location of the Privy Council hearings. Now let us look at the flowchart representation of the hierarchy of the criminal justice system in India. Supreme Court is at the apex, followed by the High Court. High Court is followed by the Session Judges Court, then Assistant Session Judges. Assistant Session Judges are further assisted by the Chief Judicial Magistrate and Chief Metropolitan Magistrate. The Chief Judicial Magistrate are having two subdivisions, Judicial Magistrate of the class and Special Judicial Magistrate. Now this is about the hierarchy of the criminal justice system. Criminal justice system, the cases involving the Criminal Act. Now let us look at the hierarchy of the civil judicial system. Civil judicial system means the cases involving the family matters or other than the criminal cases that are existing falls under the civil judicial system in India. For dispute, marriage, divorce, registration of land, property, all this comes under the civil judicial system. Here in this court, Supreme Court is at the apex, followed with the High Court, then the District Court and additional district judges, followed with the subordinate judges class 1 and subordinate judges class 2. Subordinate judges class 2 are subdivided into court of small causes for metropolitan cities and Munsif's court or court of subjudge 3 class. This is about the hierarchy of the judiciary involving the civil cases. Under the mentioned hierarchy of the courts, the decisions given by the Supreme Court is the higher authority and its decision are binding on all other courts throughout the territory of India. While the decisions given by the high courts are binding onto the subordinate courts within the jurisdiction of that particular high court. The decision of the high courts are not binding beyond their respective jurisdictions. The decisions of the high courts, however, have persuasive value for the other high courts and the subordinate court beyond their jurisdiction. Now, it is very important to note that the Supreme Court is not bound by the previous decisions, with an exception that a smaller bench is bound by the decision of larger bench and that of the co-equal bench. That this means that Supreme Court is not bound by the previous decisions. Only in case when the benches are set for particular cases and has to be considered in regard to the particular matter that is being discussed. Now let us move on to the next topic and check, do judges make law? Discussion in the foregoing paragraphs regarding the hierarchy of the courts and the binding authority of the decisions of the Supreme Court in the lower court raises another important question regarding the role of the judges in lawmaking. This part of the topic deals with the fundamental question, do judges make law? The Indian Constitution confers power onto the legislature to make laws, while the judiciary has the power to examine the constitutionality of the law, whether it is according to the provision of the Constitution or not, enacted by the legislature. The courts also adjudicate upon the rights and duties of the citizens and further interpret the provisions of the Constitution and other statutes. Now here you can see the alongside picture given of Justice Harilal J.K. Sundas Kania was the first Chief Justice of India. Now through this process, if we talk about, the courts create new rights for the citizens. By this exercise, we can rightly say that judiciary also makes additions to the existing laws of the country. If it is not making a new law, it can make additions to the existing laws of the country. It is argued that while doing this, judges actually make law. There are two views regarding this issue. One set of jurists say that judges do not make the law, but that they simply declare the existing law. Another set of jurists say that judges do make the law. For example, jurists like Edward Coke and Matthew Hale are of the opinion that judges do not make law. According to them, judicial decisions are not sources of law, but they are simply the proof of what the law is. Judges are not lawgivers, but they discover law. At the same time, jurists like Dicey, Gray, Salmond are of the opinion that judges do make law. They hold the view that the judges, while interpreting the law enacted by the legislative bodies, contribute to the existing body of law. A large part of the English law is judge-made law. The above arguments seem to be complementary. It can be inferred that, inferred means drawn conclusion, that judges do not make the law in the same manner in which the legislative bodies do. Judges work on a given legal material passed as by the legislature. While declaring the law, judges interpret the legislation in question and play a creative role. By this creative role, judges have contributed significantly to the development of law. In the Indian context, if we talk about, former judges of the Supreme Court of India like Justice P.N. Bhagwati and Justice Krishna Iyer enlarged the meaning and scope of various provisions of the Constitution through their creative interpretation of the legal text. The Supreme Court, too, in its role as through an activist, has created many new rights, such as the right to privacy, right to live in a pollution-free environment, right to livelihood, etc. Right to education has received considerable impetus during the last decade as a result of the concerted effort of many groups and agencies towards ensuring that all children in India receive at least minimum education, irrespective of their socio-economic status and their ability to pay for education. In a situation of continuous impoverishment and erosion of the basic needs, in a way, the right to education is the culmination of efforts made possible by judicial interpretation and constitutional amendment. So this is one of the example where it is due to the efforts of the jurist and the judicial interpretation that the constitutional amendment was made possible and right to education has been declared as a fundamental right added on by the judiciary. Now these new rights were created only by the way of interpreting Article 21, right to life. The above right that we have read, right to privacy, right to property, all this is under the interpretation of the judges of Article 21, right to life of the Constitution of India. These rights developed by the courts are not in any sense lesser than the laws erected by the legislative bodies. Therefore, it can be concluded that the judicial precedents are important sources of law in modern society, and judges do play a significant role in lawmaking. Now, assignment that has to be done in Chapter 3, Part 4 are as follows. Number 1. Do judges make laws? Number 2. What is the hierarchy of courts in India? Number 3. Write a note on the hierarchy of courts in India. Number 4. What do you mean by the federal courts in India? All these answers you will write down in your classwork copy. In next session, Unit 2, Nature and Sources of Law, Chapter 3, Part 5, Sources of Law, we will continue with the chapter. Om Namah Shivaya.